In 1960, the Bay Area Electric Railroad Association purchased property at Rio Vista Junction to start constructing what would become the California Railway Museum and ultimately the Western Railway Museum as we all know it today. By the end of the decade of the 1960s, a yearly fixture of excursion trains on the SP from Oakland to Cannon and then forded to Rio Vista Junction via the Sacramento Northern had been established. A total of 5 trains operated between 1968 and 1971, with all trips originating out of Oakland's 16th Street Station. From Oakland, the trains would head east out of Martinez via the SP Makoko line to Tracy. From there, they would head north on the San Joaquin Valley line before reaching Sacramento and turning west to Elvis Tower to rejoin the Cal P and head for Cannon, where the train was then forded to the Sacramento Northern for the final leg of the trip to Rio Vista Junction. The first trip in 1968 was billed as the Kite Route Excursion and ran on April 21st, with the subsequent 4 trains after that all being billed as the Rio Vista Junction Limited, with those trips being run on April 13th and 20th, 1969, April 12th, 1970, and April 4th, 1971. The following sequences will showcase 8mm and Super 8mm movies from 4 different railfans, with near complete coverage of the whole journey from Oakland to Cannon, both on board the train and trackside. The consists will vary throughout, as these films were taken during different excursion years. It is 1971, and the location is Oakland's 16th Street Station. The last edition of the Rio Vista Junction Limited is seen preparing to board passengers. On the rear of the train is WMK 752 Circumnavigators Club. At this time, the car was privately owned by then Association Chairman Bill Kluver. The car has since been donated to the Western Railway Museum, where it is now on display. The train has now left 16th Street and is arriving at Berkeley, where additional passengers will board. Once leaving Berkeley, Alameda County is quickly left behind as San Pablo Bay comes into view, and the railroad takes a snaky water level passage into Contra Costa County. only tunnel on the CalPeak, located between Rodeo and Selby. The fan trip is seen stopping at Crockett, a station that will no longer be used for any passenger service within 3 weeks of this film being shot. Some views inside the train. East of Martinez, fast running through the flatlands of eastern Contra Costa and San Joaquin counties is the order, as the SP Depot at Port Chicago is passed. The Santa Fe main line between Richmond and Stockton is visible at the right of the screen. South of Elk Grove, we get one of our first trackside views as we see the 1970 edition of the train heading east on the San Joaquin line with a single SDP-45 on the point. The 1971 edition of the Rio Vista Junction Limited is seen along Elvis Avenue in Sacramento in these pacing sequences. The 1970 Consys turns west onto the Cal P at Elvis Tower. The train is seen arriving into Sacramento from both onboard and trackside. From onboard the train, SP4294, the last surviving cab forward, is seen stored at the SP Sacramento shops. The engine is now on permanent indoor display at the California State Railroad Museum. As can be seen when compared to the previous sequence in 1970, the same general consist is being pulled by four GP9s. The power variety on these trains is of note when studying horsepower figures. What was done with 4,500 horsepower and 3 units in 1968 and 1969 took 3,600 horsepower from a single unit in 1970. And now, here in 1971, a whopping 7,000 horsepower from four GP9s. West of Sacramento is straight, flat, double track running until Davis. The 1971 excursion is seen in two different vignettes within the vicinity of the Yolo Causeway, located on a floodplain and overflow area for the Sacramento River. Thank you. The 1970 excursion is seen arriving at Cannon. Now at Cannon, the SDP-45 will be cut off and replaced by Sacramento Northern ALCO S2-404 for the final leg to Rio Vista Junction. We see the crew lining the crossover. The SDP-45 will be switched onto the spur at Cannon, once used for the loading of livestock. The SN-404 has been sitting on the interchange track with the SP and will be joined up to the fan trip consist. With the SN-404 now in charge, the train leaves Cannon for Rio Vista Junction. The same operation is viewed from on board the train in 1968, but the power for this trip is a trio of three classic SP-FP7s. We get a better glimpse of these classic 567 workhorses sitting at Cannon as the train slowly makes its way onto the SN. The 1971 edition of the train is seen coming into Dozier off of the Cannon branch, where the train will turn east on the original Sacramento Northern main line and then shove west to Rio Vista Junction. 1970 excursion is seen shoving into Rio Vista Junction from atop the Highway 12 overpass. Note on this trip, the 2901, formerly owned by the Central Coast Railway Club, is the private car. The car is today preserved at Railtown 1897 State Historic Park. Moving back to track level, we see the 1971 edition of the train making its arrival, with the Circumnavigators Club leading the charge on the shove. Now at Rio Vista Junction, it's time for a pleasant afternoon of juice and steam, with a look back at the museum as it appeared between 1968 and 1971. Under steam for the occasion is Pickering 3 Truck Shay No. 11. This locomotive was built in 1929 by the Lima Locomotive Works and operated at the museum from the late 1960s into the late 1970s. The engine was never considered part of the museum collection and was privately owned by Tom Erian. It has since been moved to the Mount Rainier Scenic Railroad. After the festivities at Rio Vista Junction, the 1971 excursion is seen at Dozier and on the Cannon Branch. Now at Cannon, the interchange back to SP is complete, and it's back to Oakland and the end of the trip.